Hello everyone, Rafael Manga from Iron Vibes here, and today we'll show how to hack Ableton to use his native Clipper plugin.
Well, Ableton already have a Clipper, but it doesn't give us all the control over it. We will manipulate the signal to have the clip control. If you didn't notice, the Clipper is inside of the glue compressor and saturator. And I didn't use the Clipper from saturator because it isn't so transparent as the Clipper from glue compressor. So I will show how to control the signal. Here I have an input, control input, and here an output, right? And the main thing. Here we have a utility before and another one after to manipulate the level of signal. This way we can have the threshold where we want. As you can see here and here, when I increase this one, will bring the level, and this other one will compensate. When we compensate the levels, we don't change anything in the song. Look. We are compensating. But if I decrease 5 dBs and increase 5 dBs, what's happened? But for this glue compressor, it's different because we are manipulating the threshold. More signal in, less signal out, so the output level is the same, but we are manipulating the threshold of this plugin glue compressor. I left minus 1.9 here and more 1.9 here.
I don't remember why, but
I made a lot of tests because glue compressor doesn't have the clip at 0 dB, so this way I could preserve the threshold at 0 dB. And for this curve, I mapped the range for this compressor. Actually, when we have 0 at curve, the range of glue compressor is 0.
What it mean?
Doesn't compressing anything. We are using only the soft clip. If we increase the curve, the glue compressor starts to acting as a compressor. I will show an example with a kick drum. I think it will be easy to explain. We have a kick here. I will start with 0. It means hard curve. I will increase the output. Only to explain, look at this curve of clipping. It is squared, right? When I increase the curve, look at this curve. It starts to be rounded. I used a limiter after all of this because to avoid clip the signal if we go too much in the output. It's only a safe limiter. Let me show the macros that I use. Output here, I left minus 20 dB for less and more. The same for input here, I mapped here for input. The curve, I mapped to range, curve, left 0 until 70, and the clip, I mapped these two gains, remember, one to compensate other, minus 1.9 until 35 dB, and the other positive 1.9 dB until infinity. If you don't know how to use a clipper, in this video I show some examples that clipper is very useful. If you didn't follow me and made yours, this clipper is free for download. Just access rmvibes.com or the website link in the description and go to the tab free downloads, and you will find it there with many other free downloads. Thanks for watching, and if you learned something on this video, don't forget to like the video, subscribe to this channel, and ring the bell. See you in the next video.